In this example, I'm going to look at a first-order catalytic reaction that takes place in a catalysphere. And we're given an effectiveness factor of 0.8, which means the rate is 80% of the rate we would obtain if the concentration everywhere in the catalyst was the same as at the external surface. We want to now take and make the same catalytic material into a larger catalysphere and determine how much more the rate increases if we increase the diameter by a factor of 4. So the first thing we want to do is write down the information we have, make a diagram. So the effectiveness factor is going to change. It's 0.8 for the smaller particle. It's going to decrease for the larger particle because of the longer diffusion distance. We'll call the area we have for reaction A1. So this is the area within the pores. The area A2 is going to increase because we have more volume. And so the surface area is proportional to the volume. So this means that 4 cubed times A1 corresponds to the area for A2 because the volume 2 is 4 cubed times the volume 1. The external surface concentration of a reactant is the same in both cases, and the rate constant's the same. We're doing this isothermally. And so what we're interested in then is the ratio of the rate of reactions at these two conditions. So we first need to determine the effectiveness factor. And so in order to do that, we need to determine the Thiele modulus. So the effectiveness factor is related to the Thiele modulus by this equation. And there's more than one way to define the Thiele modulus. This is the hyperbolic cotangent. This is certainly a nonlinear equation. We can solve this in a spreadsheet, use solver. And when this is 0.8, then we can determine the Thiele modulus. And so this Thiele modulus is strictly from solving this equation. Now the Thiele modulus can be defined in slightly different ways. The way I've defined it here is the radius of the particle, the ratio of the rate constant over the effective diffusivity in this porous catalyst. And so this means our new Thiele modulus is going to be 4 times the old one because the radius increased a factor 4. We can now substitute our new Thiele modulus in to determine our new value for effectiveness factor. So when we do this calculation, we have the new effectiveness factor. You can see the catalyst is less effective because of the longer diffusion distance. And then we can determine the rate in the larger catalyst pellet over the rate in the smaller one. So it's an effectiveness factor, the rate constant, the concentration at the surface, and then the surface area. Rate constants and concentrations are the same. So what we have is the ratio of effectiveness factors and the ratio of area. And so this means our ratio of rates is 25.8, which is approximately, for number of significant figures here, 26. So the surface area increased a factor of 64, but the rate only increased a factor of 26 because of the longer diffusion distance and the catalyst is being used less effectively.